Thank you.
Mama used them to hoist him out of his crib.
Sir, I'll show you to the headmaster.
Thank you.
Chipping? We've never had a chipping here.
Indeed, headmaster. It's chipping as in Chipping Norton. Or if you should prefer, Chipping Camden.
I've never been to Chipping Norton or to Chipping Camden. And which, as you say, I might very well prefer. Now, look here, Chipping. The agency says you're worth a second chance. And indeed, here at Brookfield, we believe in the second chance. We believe in giving a second chance. Now, the boys are, I warn you, most energetic. Most. And if in your previous school, if discipline proved a problem...
If I might explain, Headmaster.
The fact is, Chipping, our Latin master's gone. He came into a huge inheritance. But there's still a month of term. Ideal trial period. Yes, we can always think again. I mean, after that, with the... Can't you take the lower fifth now? Chipping, declensions, conjugations, no striving necessary.
Oh, yes, Headmaster. Thank you, Headmaster.
Oh, thank you, Chipping. Now, rather desperate. Ah, Rivers. Good man. This is Mr. Chipping. He's taking the lower fifth for Latin. Would you show him there, please?
Yes, Master. Yes.
We'd better get you accustomed to Brookfield language, sir. Otherwise, you shan't know what we're talking about, shall you, sir? A boy shan't ask matron for a glass of milk. He asks for a tot of dolly. He mustn't wear his gutties in dorm. Gutties are for cricket. Nor shall a boy wear his pigs in dorm either. Why not, sir? Because his pigs are his boots.
What do you say? It's Rivers.
The upper third. Beastly are young beasts. Like all young beasts, need restraint. Henshaw, you little oik, you burnt my toast again this morning.
Sorry, Rivers, I won't do it again.
Wrong, oik, I won't do it again. Suggest you did it deliberately. You should say I shan't let it happen again. What should you say, oik?
I shan't let it happen again, Rivers.
Oh. The standard of fagging this year is deplorable.
This is Mr. Chipping. He will take you for Latin. All the books you shall need in the drawer, sir.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon, sir.
Thank you.
For some, I can. For Taze, you can. Protest.
May I inquire as to the nature of your unannounced recreation,
Please, sir, he's playing possum.
Playing possum?
Playing possum, sir. Like opossum, the animal, sir. Pretending to be dead, sir.
Take 100 lines and resume your desk.
Oh, sir, I can't do lines. I hurt my arm when I fell.
200 lines and sit, please.
Oh, I feel ill.
Lines after school in this classroom.
From 2 o'clock tomorrow, every boy in the lower fifth will present himself at my office for caning. Alphabetical order, one boy every 5 minutes. Resume your books. The staff room, I think.
Chipping, Latin.
Glass of brandy.
Thank you, no.
What was that row?
Hello, I'm Stafford. I do German.
Chipping, I do Latin, I hope.
Was that your baptism of fire we heard?
I say, if you're Latin, it's your night for prep.
Ah, come. A change of plan.
Headmaster.
Could you possibly take prep?
Headmaster, please.
I think, Chipping, in the light of the scene I just witnessed...
Headmaster, please, you've only just put my name down. I should dearly hope... A second chance, I believe you said, Headmaster, that at Brookfield...
Forgive me, Chipping, I've already asked...
Headmaster, if the boys hear the behaviour proved coercive...
Oh, very well. As you were...
That car.
How do you do?
They put a pigeon in my desk on my first day. Said it was a homing pigeon. I called it Friedrich.
I do know how to teach.
You have some hours before prep starts. Go out. Out there under the sky. Look around. What is the saying? Distance lends enchantment to the view. Go out. Come back refreshed.
Seeking inspiration?
No, sir.
Henshaw, is it? What are you doing?
Sir, a prefect gave me a halfpenny to pay for an errand. And I've lost it, sir. If I don't find it, he'll thrash me.
Well, you should be more careful, shouldn't you? Henshaw. Be more careful.
careful with that. Hmm?
Thank you, sir.
Jeter, Jerry, Clark, Cochran,
yes, sir.
Colley,
yes, sir.
Copeland,
yes, sir.
Deverill,
yes, sir.
Dexter.
Yes, sir.
Boy at the head of the table immediately behind me, please stand up.
He can't hurt you. Do you mean me, sir?
I do, yes. What is your name?
Collie, sir.
Collie? Is not a collie a dog? When I was a boy, I believe, I had a dog of that breed. His name was Rover. Very well. Rover, slamming down your book twice, thereby denying other boys their right to study, you will stay behind. And in your detention, you will write 100 times. A dog will never behave like a boy, but a boy will sometimes behave like a dog. In Latin. I shall be interested in your translation. Well now, Rover, sit.
Bailey, Easton, Bell, Watson.
Hope you're getting them all!
When you consider that Metcalf is a housemaster, does one really want to be a housemaster?
Pick those feet up, Brookfield man! Pick those feet up!
All the same, I should like to be asked.
So should I.
Good Roland, keep going.
Collins, well done. Well, but I shan't get it. I have become philosophical about my ambition. Makes me avoid disappointment. Have we done?
Yes, I think so. Oh, no. All the dice. Oh. Right, that's enough. Let's get you back, all the dice.
Please, sir. I want to run.
Don't talk nonsense. Let's get you back.
Watch out.
All the dice! Get back on the trail at once! Chipping! What do you believe you're doing?
Oh, come on, old man. He's been in the sanatorium since term day.
Do not mollycoddle him.
Do you want him to be ill again? No, Metcalf, this is not good.
Very well. Alder Dice, be a milksop. See how that will profit you.
Really, Metcalf? Come on, Alder Dice.
Come on, boys! Alder Dice is on holiday!
15 minutes to full change, everyone. Well done, hounds. Very well done. Well done, Hare. Where are you? Jolly good trail. Well done. So, well done, everyone. Or nearly everyone.
And by all means, expect Cicero. They're obsessed with Cicero at Cambridge.
Yes, sir.
You should feel very confident, Hawthorne. I've not had a student at Brookfield who prepared so thoroughly. Oh, come on, Hawthorne, what is it?
Sir, it's just that I've been a scholarship boy at Brookfield and been made to feel pretty low on account of it.
Hawthorne, scholarships honour the intellect. Our bursaries here make Brookfield very, very special to me.
But, sir, everyone here knows they only go to the unwealthy. And everyone at Cambridge will know that too.
Doesn't the quality of the mind outweigh all social considerations? When you graduate from Cambridge, and I feel certain that you shall gain entry there, and I feel certain you shall graduate with distinction, help whom you can to use their minds well. That will level the score, hmm? Now would be a good time to feel ashamed, gentlemen.
So this is our house initiation?
It's barbaric, Reinhardt. Barbaric. I've said so before, and I shall go on saying it until good behavior supervenes.
But, sir, I was barreled.
Precisely, and it made you a barbarian. Now get to your house.
You're supposed to stay there until fetched. Now you will have to do it all over again.
Please, sir. It wasn't my fault, sir.
Alderdice is innocent in this.
Alderdice, go to bed.
Put some dry clothes on, Alderdice.
Chipping, did you halt the barreling?
Interest omnium rectet facere.
Speak English.
It is for the good of all to do right.
I am Alderdice's housemaster, not you.
Year, decade, mollycoddling the little beast. Can you imagine? Running noses, stomach aches. Not for me. I've told the headmaster as much.
Oh?
Oh, no, I didn't mean it would be quite the thing for you.
Oh.
Hey!
Lost that.
What's going on? Someone's on the roof.
Careful. Come on, you're nearly there.
Oh,
Sexton!
Be careful!
Sexton!
He's safe, sir.
Well, fetch a ladder! Quickly! Sexton, are you all right?
Yes!
Hold still. Do not move a muscle.
Yes, Sexton, hold on!
What is going on?
A patch of misdemeanor, headmaster. A bolter. A roof. A boy who ought to know better.
Address it, would you, Mr. Chipping? I shall want to know.
Headmaster?
Main prep room, Sexton. 10 minutes.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Come. Close the door, Sexton. Come stand in front of me. Put your boater down. Raise both your arms and hold out each hand with the palm flat and upward. Now, Sexton, it is a distinct contravention of Brookfield's rubric to climb a roof. Why, Sexton? Because danger lies inherent. Therefore, I must address this willful misdemeanor of yours. You heard the headmaster, hmm? Very well. Get out, Sexton.
Thank you, sir.
I'm in. Cambridge has accepted me. I'm in.
Oh, well done, Hawthorne. That's wonderful news. Well done.
Oh, no, sir. Well done to you. I could not have done it without you.
No, Hawthorne. In life, there are matters of character and there are matters of behaviour. Passing that examination was a matter of character. Good character. Highest praise, Hawthorne. Highest praise.
Come in.
You sent for me, Headmaster.
Ah, yes, Jimmy. Do sit down. Now, Jimmy, I sent for you regarding the position of the new housemaster.
Yes, headmaster.
It's a position of some gravity, you know.
Indeed it is, headmaster.
The position of a housemaster is one which requires an egregious range of values. Duties in a house extend far above and beyond those of a classroom. A different dedication, a redirected perception, and so forth. You do not, I feel sure, require a recital.
Indeed. In fact, I find myself so much in agreement that a recital would be superfluous.
Good. I'm grateful. So, bearing in mind all things, I've decided to offer the position to Stiefel.
Yes, headmaster. An excellent choice.
Thank you, Chipping. That will be all, Chipping.
Headmaster, may I inquire as to why... I mean, so to speak, why I was not chosen?
You know, Chipping, I sometimes think that giving reasons for one's actions is a rather futile gesture. You do understand what I mean, don't you?
Yes, Headmaster. Thank you.
All the dice. All the dice, come here.
I haven't seen you since your ordeal. How are you? Are you going home for the holes?
Come on, yes. Racing.
Oh, my God. I wish I were going with you. You will be careful.
I think I must avoid being careful, Max. It has availed me little. Nor, if I'm truthful, has being careless proved particularly useful. If you were my housemaster and I a senior boy, how would you now advise me?
Goodbye, sir.
I found that when I stopped judging myself harshly, the world became kinder to me. Remember I told you once, go out, look around the world. Do that now. Only this time, let the world look at you. My dear friend, I assure you, the world will like what it sees.
Cheerio, Max. Madam, is everything in order? You appear to be in a position of some possible peril.
No peril. Thank you. You know why I'm up here?
I don't.
It's my vantage point. You see, from up here, I can see the fish perfectly. Did you know that fish are so much more visible when viewed from above?
Indeed, there have been murmurs to this effect.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Hold on! Keep quite still. Now, steady. That's it. I've got you. Just fall. Oh! Are you all right?
I am now. Thank you. Who are you?
Oh, just someone on holiday. Nobody, really.
Well, nobody's nobody. Or is nobody actually your name? Richard Nobody, David Nobody.
Actually, my name is Chipping.
Walk-in party, but I escaped. They didn't want to look at the fish. I did. What are you, Mr. Chipping? Are you a solicitor?
No.
Are you a stockbroker? A dentist?
No, not a stockbroker. Not a dentist.
Not a stockbroker, not a dentist. Are you a man with a cotton business in Manchester?
No, I'm a teacher.
Oh, how wonderful!
Shelter, perhaps. Here. Oh. In here.
Oh, heavens!
Oh, here. I have a cake.
You know, a teacher is the very best thing to be.
Well, I used to think so.
Oh, yes. Think of the wonderful gifts you give.
Gifts?
Well, think of the gift you gave when you told someone where Mesopotamia is. Or when you taught someone the length of the River Nile.
I am Latin, not geography.
Well, think of the gift you give when you teach someone Cicero. Or Lucretius.
Do you truly think teaching's like this?
Truly. It's terribly important. It is the most important thing there is.
Madam.
I'm not called Madam. I'm called Catherine Bridges. And everyone calls me Cathy, Mr. Chipping. Mr. Chipping. I expect your pupils call you Chips.
No, I don't believe they call me that.
Well, I shall. How do you do, Mr. Chips?
Is that your walking party?
Oh.
Come along now, best foot forward.
There they are.
Year? Room 22. And do not smoke your pipe in the bath.
Let's celebrate it more. Very convenient. I wonder if. Ah!
I'm sorry. Nobody wants to play. They're going to have a soiree, they say. But we can't play with three. Excuse me, forgive my intrusion, but could you bear to make up a four?
How kind. I'd be delighted. Oh. I'm not very good, I'm afraid.
Neither are we, so that'll be splendid.
Would you mind most awfully if I sat in that chair?
No.
Thank you. Thank you.
Come to the Lord, for the black bear tonight has flown. Come to the garden, I am he that lay down.
Young man?
No, I don't, but I am quite musical.
No, play your hand. We're waiting. Your lead.
Oh, so sorry.
My husband was a much worse singer.
Shh! Listen. Oh. Oh, good morning.
Hello.
I didn't know that you were... Yes, I am.
Oh,
yes, yes. It's very pleasant, isn't it?
Well, I think you are up early.
Yes, much to do, Miss Bridges.
Kathy. Yes?
No, I was just repeating your name.
What is your much to do, Mr. Chips?
Oh, well, I'd heard there were some ruins nearby.
Oh, you mean my walking party?
Well, I wondered if, is it possible? Could you join me? It's not very interesting, and I'm rather dull company. Dry as dust, I fear.
We shall join you. We shall sweep off. Do you bicycle?
Don't look down.
Don't look down?
Don't look down.
I'm looking straight ahead. Does that help? That's almost fun.
What's that?
Well, take care.
Women have never voted. I feel we've stayed out too late for supper. I'm most awfully sorry.
But don't you think women have the right to be doctors?
I do hope you're not too hungry.
Oh, do stop trying to change the subject, Mr. Chips. Women would make good doctors. We're wonderful healers. And we civilize matters.
Well, yes, I suppose, if you put it like that, yes.
Do you like Mr. George Bernard Shaw?
Never ask myself that question. But if I do ask the question, the answer is no.
But he says wonderful things.
He says very unsettling things.
Like women should be allowed to vote. Thank you for a wonderful day.
Oh, to the contrary. Thank you for making such a wonderful companion. If we were were we to meet?
Let us shake hands, like we did before. You know, I leave tomorrow.
Catherine!
The train leaves at 7:20, remember?
I'd no idea.
Do come and bid me goodbye.
Morning, my dear.
Morning.
Come along, Catherine. Time to be off.
Catherine?
Almost ready.
Has just left. She asked me to give you this.
Would you mind? Thank you.
Thank you.
What is the fellow doing?
Good heavens.
I hope you're not going to forget yourself, my dear.
I believe I already have.
Chipping's got married.
She got married, did she?
That must be her.
Did he tell you, Stephen?
I had no idea, but I say well done.
Yes, but imagine what she must look like. I mean, marrying Chipping.
Oh, good. Gentlemen, may I introduce my wife, Catherine?
Welcome to Brookfield, Mrs. Chipping.
Max
Stafford,
Catherine Chipping.
Thank you. Thank you.
Exquisite! Hold that jacket carefully, it's warm.
Here,
thank you. Wonderful.
Wonderful. Now you must be the photography club. Hello, what's your name?
What is the Latin term for dark horse? Hmm? I told you, my dear friend, the world would like what it saw in you. What? She is adorable.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, Mrs. Chipping, come.
Now, you must all come to tea. Hmm? All of you. And you, Miss Staple.
No one of me.
Now we know that the chronicles of the Romans in Britain were written by a scribe with first-hand knowledge and experience. To whom do I refer, please, gentlemen? Yes, Colley.
Please, sir, it was Tacitus.
Indeed it was, Colley. And who was Tacitus's father-in-law? And Colley, please do not say as you usually do, well, sir, it wasn't me.
It was Agricola, sir.
Very gratifying, Colley. I hope you will impart this knowledge to your brother. I singularly failed to do so. Good morning, headmaster.
Good morning, headmaster.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, Mr. Chipping.
Headmaster.
Letting some fresh air into the classroom, I see.
Yes, it was my wife's idea, sir.
It's a jolly good idea. Is your wife settling in?
Oh, very much so, sir. Yes, she's still exploring a little.
I should like to find something for her to do in the school.
Well, I think you should find her most receptive, sir.
Yes.
Gentlemen, dismiss. Quietly, if you please. Festina lente. Colley, since it seems your day to shine, translate, please.
Hasten slowly, sir.
As words to deep, Colley, and words to deep.
I'll give you something to really love about. Come on, Rushton. Oh, you
stop your morning foot. Calm down.
What are you doing?
Chipping's coming.
What is the meaning of this? Golden, Cooper, Park. Be ashamed. Wallingford. Fifth form prep room. This instant!
Yes, sir.
Come here, Russ.
now, Anthony. I should be very gentle.
Rushton, is there anything you might have done to make Wallingford think you had provoked him in this action?
Please, sir. My mother has died and I was blubbing, sir.
Thank you.
James, this is frightful. Why did this boy Wallingford do this sort of thing? Are you going to cane him?
I don't know. Sit down. What is your model in all this? What or who convinces you that this is the behavior of a gentleman? Wallingford, I shall be seeing the headmaster later this evening. He may wish to expel you.
The headmaster likes to sit with his elbows on the table.
So we allow him room to do so?
No, Catherine. Mrs. Weatherby doesn't like him to sit with his elbows on the table. Huh? So, as ever, with the headmaster, you have to try and judge how far he wishes to take the matter. Therefore, we leave him room enough to take the decision, should he so wish.
No, I believe soup is the most natural food for man.
Oh, man.
I believe it. You see, it returns us to the point whence we sprang. Mr. Darwin says...
Not him again.
Mr. Darwin says we all rose from a kind of soup, a primitive soup, with all the ingredients that make man what he is.
Not too much salt, I trust.
Mrs. Chipping, I do hope that you did not encounter Mr. Darwin's soup in your education, which I gather was a private one.
Two governesses, headmaster. Miss Flint and Miss Steele.
Well, most promising names.
Yes, sir. As for school life, I find some of it quite surprising, headmaster.
Who?
My husband and I, we loathe bullying.
Some theorists suggest a great school like this should mirror the kind of world the boys will encounter outside.
But bullying is uncivilized, is it not, headmaster?
Mrs. Chipping, I find the idea of private education very intriguing. Your governesses, were they generalists, by which I mean did each teach all subjects, or did they specialize?
Headmaster, forgive me, I saw that poor boy, Rushton. I saw him this afternoon.
Rushton, enlighten me.
He'd been most horribly bullied.
A great school like Brookfield needs a number of hierarchies. It helps keep things in order. It's why we have prefects.
Max, he was in a dreadful state. And all because his bully found him weeping. Rushton's mother had just died. And the poor boy was being bullied for grieving. That is unconscionable.
Do we know the culprit?
Wallingford, headmaster.
I trust that you caned him, and jolly severely, I hope.
No, headmaster.
Why ever not?
It hasn't worked in the past, not with Wallingford anyway, nor anyone else, really.
I feel he must be a deeply unhappy child.
No, no. Wallingford has behaved appallingly since the day he came to this school. If you can't find it in you to punish him, Chipping, I can.
Headmaster, may I suggest this is the wrong course of action?
The point is, Catherine...
Look, there must be some means of altering Wallingford's behaviour.
I do think, Mrs. Chipping, that the running of the school ought properly to be undertaken by the teaching staff.
Headmaster, do you know the fable of the sun and the north wind? The sun and the north wind were arguing one day as to who possessed the greatest powers. Observe, said the north wind. Observe that man down there. See how I shall blow his coat from his shoulders. So the north wind blew, icier and icier. But of course the man simply wrapped his coat even tighter around his shoulders. And then the sun gently said, North wind, you've had your opportunity. Please, allow me. And the sun shone. Warmer and warmer. And the man took off his coat.
Good night.
Thank you. Oh, Chips, have I ruined everything?
Oh, now, none of that. Of course you haven't.
I have something so good to tell you.
What?
You're going to become something else. Something new.
Oh, well, what more do I want to be? I'm a Latin teacher and a husband.
Think.
No. Really? Mm-hmm. Are you certain? Oh, my word. Oh, well done.
Wallingford?
Good morning, Mr. Chipping.
Could I have a word with you?
Mrs. Chipping has proposed that we invite some girls from Meadowland Academy for a social evening. I find the idea rather progressive for my taste, but perhaps it has aspect.
Headmaster, I don't want to stand in the way of progress, but this is a boys' school. Yeah. And furthermore, without wishing to belabour any hidden point, the school is run by teachers under your guidance, Headmaster.
Headmaster. In France, boys at a school like Brookfield are encouraged towards social skills. They are even taught to dance.
Well, happily, we are not in France, Mr. Steffel.
One, two, three, four, and three. You have to turn towards each other. You have to imagine Jonathan's a young lady. Chip, will you help me demonstrate?
Of course, yes, by all means.
When you turn, you must always turn inwards. Turn in towards your partner.
Adam.
Thank you, Max. Chins up. One, two, three, four. Turn in.
Now remember, you are young gentlemen. You must uphold the reputation of this house.
Indeed. Come on, girls.
And I said to him, Dickie Bird, why
say, Chips, old chap, I think I know what you and your lady wife are up to.
Up to?
Yes. You want to get everyone married, just like yourselves.
Not me, old chap. Not me.
Do you know Miss Robbins from Meadowlands? Miss Robbins, this is our Mr. Burnley of geography. Would you excuse me?
Miss Robbins. How do you do?
With a shake of his poor little head, he replies, oh, Willow, it will all, it will all.
Boys! Boys, return to your dormitory at once.
Mr. Metcalf, do you dance?
Dance?
A wandering minstrel, I, a thing of shreds and patches, of ballad songs and snatches, and dreamy lullabies.
This is well lit. Welcome.
This all seems to be most successful, Chipping.
Yes, well, everyone seems to be enjoying themselves.
Wallingford. Thank you. Good night. I tune myself.
Mrs. Chipping.
I'm also called Kathy.
Kathy, Mrs. Chipping, I feel I do owe you an apology.
No apology is needed when you dance so beautifully.
Chipping, a word.
Excuse us.
On maiden's coldness do you brood, I'll do so too.
Now look here, Chipping. I'm making some changes. I want you to run Wellington House. With Mrs. Chipping, of course, an essential cog in the Brookfield machine now, don't you know?
Thank you, Headmaster.
My congratulations, Mrs. Chipping. The sun again seems to have triumphed over the north wind.
Oh, thank you, Headmaster.
And you'll find Wellington House very spacious.
Wellington? Oh,
Miss John.
I wish to thank you, Headmaster, for allowing us the pleasure of meeting such well-mannered boys.
The headmaster has charged us with running Wellington House.
Congratulations, Chips. Congratulations, Kathy.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
We'll also observe how Latin informs you in your other disciplines. For example, who has not yet heard of the geometry theorem we call pons asinorum, the bridge of donkeys? We call it this. Because it is the bridge of learning at which so many donkeys falter.
On the left, please, Charles. Would you both like tea?
Please, Mum.
Come on, dear, let me in.
I'm all right. Yeah, I had no idea you had so many books.
Hmm? Oh, you gave me that one.
We could call him Albert.
Yes, or Victoria.
Or Edward.
Or Helena.
Alice.
I rather like Leopold.
We shall be fine.
I'll come and tell you the good news.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you, Doctor. Victoria or Albert?
My dear fellow.
Boy or a girl?
There were complications.
Well, I think not. My wife is very straightforward.
No.
No.
I'm sorry. Mrs. Chipping did not survive. We tried to save both. We saved neither.
No, my wife is a very heavy sleeper. We joke about it.
No, my dear fellow. Not just yet.
And the child?
It would have been Albert.
Today, gentlemen, we will return to the familiar territory of the Gallic Wars of Caesar.
Please, sir.
We shall as ever translate.
Please, sir. You've received rather a lot of letters, sir.
book two from the beginning. Who shall volunteer?
When Caesar was in yonder Gaul.
Hither Gaul.
In hither Gaul. In winter quarters.
Sorry I'm late, sir.
As we have shown above, frequent rumours were brought to him. And he was also informed by letters from Labienus that all the Belgae who have said are a third.
Mr. Ralston.
Welcome. We were not expecting you until later in the week.
And you are?
I am Chipping. I have the honor.
Latin.
Indeed, Headmaster.
Long serving, I believe. Therefore, an excellent guide for my tour of the school.
Don't look so depressed, it's only a pose.
When man is born by then this must be Herr Stiefel.
So,
Stiefel, Max Stiefel.
How long has he been here?
A wonderful teacher and colleague, Headmaster. Came here straight from Oxford, never taught anywhere else.
Chipping, am I right in assuming that Brookfield does not field an officer training corps?
Heaven forfend, Headmaster. We're trying to keep violence out of the school, not bring it in.
I would remind our esteemed Latin master that German is a living language.
Which, of course, to many of us remains its chief problem.
Oh, is our esteemed chairman in this debate now aligning himself too closely with the traditions he teaches?
After all, the Romans believed in dictatorship and in the opposing of belief and opinion under the guise of impartiality.
Gentlemen, I shall be brief. I feel as though I've spent the last few days touching the very fabric of Brookfield. And I regret to have to tell you, I find the fabric somewhat frayed. We shall have some economies, stringent economies. Perhaps merge a house or two. In any case, we must all understand that Brookfield is a school, not a charity. As of next term, our fees will rise substantially. At the same time, we need to go out and persuade people of, dare I say it, newly substantial means that their boys will profit from attending Brookfield. And with this in mind, the curriculum will be modernized to meet the needs of such, shall we say, practical parents. Therefore, gentlemen, change all round. Well, that's all I have to say for the moment.
Headmaster, Brookfield has an honourable tradition of bursaries for boys of humbler means.
Indeed it does. Thank you, gentlemen. My initial report to the governors will be circulated. In the meantime, my door is always open.
Weatherby visited the staff room so often.
Almost every day.
Mr. Ralston has been once in 2 months. What on earth?
Divert previous forms of expenditure into buildings for the new disciplines. Science, sport, the future.
Yes, well, that's all very well, Mr. Ralston, but will our Ralston be able to take off the business when our best done?
Former! Fixed bayonets. Your target will not be sitting or standing waiting. It will run at you or away from you. Troop, bayonets at the ready. By the right, quick, march! On stride. Charge!
Heavens! Highcroft! Discipline this idiot!
Sorry, sir. Aaron's fallen.
That was beyond impertinence.
Yes, sir.
Slowly, boys, slowly.
One moment, please.
Master, I wish, if possible, to have a word.
Actually, Herr Staple, I was wishing a word with you. Do come in, Sir John. Yes. Yes, please.
He said he had Brookfield's best interests at heart. Must look around to see what's happening in the wider world. Climate of opinion. Chips. He more or less asked me to resign.
And did you?
Of course. I'm alarmed, I'm dismayed, but I'm not surprised.
What do you mean?
Chips, you must have divined that I and the subject I teach have fallen from grace in England.
Oh, Max, you mustn't think like that. And Brookfield must not be like that. For heaven's sake, the king himself is of German descent.
There's going to be a war. None of us can help such things.
Morning, Chippy.
Max Staffel must not be allowed to leave Brookfield.
Is this your concern?
This is monstrous. You dismiss a fine teacher on the grounds of prejudice.
Herr Staffel has offered his resignation.
Under the most appalling moral pressure.
He'd be the first to admit that his position is difficult. Boys will be boys. Nonetheless, an English public school has a clear duty to foster patriotism. Or would you not agree?
Headmaster, this school is above and beyond...
Herr Staffel at least has the sense to realize that if there's a war with Germany, his position will be intolerable. Anything else?
for those of us, like Max Stiefel and myself, who have devoted our lives to Brookfield. Your record thus far is disgraceful.
Disgraceful? Do enlighten me, Chipping.
I have asked you more than once to inform me as to how many scholarship students we may expect this year. I have received no answer. I suspect you mean to cancel the Brookfield bursaries.
Suspect? I can tell you that myself. I'm obliged by the governors to make economies.
Headmaster, at Brookfield, boys of lesser means are given a wonderful chance. Why are you destroying this? This is monstrous!
How old are you, Chipping?
I have no wish, nor any need to retire.
I may not say it that way.
I beg your pardon. It seems to me, Headmaster, that you do not possess the capacity to understand or respect the qualities inherent in a school such as Brookfield.
You're trying to provoke me, Chipping. I'm charged with modernizing Brookfield. We simply cannot, I simply will not adhere to styles of education that belong to the last century.
That may arise because you do not understand them. I find them most effective.
There'll be no place for them in the new Brookfield.
Sir! Must all your movement be towards the lowering of standards? This is intolerable. I disagree with you profoundly, and I do not see that I can continue to serve under you.
In that alone, Chipping, we are of one mind.
Yes, boys, I'm as upset as you are. But, boys, we've got to think of a plan. We must have a plan, though, boys. Do we want chips? Yes, we want chips. Do we rally?
Yes, we rally. Yes, we rally. Yes, we rally. Yes, we rally.
Are we ready?
Yes, we're ready. Yes, we're ready. Yes, we're ready. Yes, we're ready.
Do we fight?
Yes, we fight. Yes, we fight.
Is there not enough talk of fighting in the world?
Sir, we're having a convocation to prevent your departure.
That's right, sir.
Oh, really, Atkins? All of you. That is most kind. But I fear you mustn't.
But, sir...
No, the headmaster has spoken. He is charged with running and improving the school. His authority cannot be questioned. We must have hierarchies in life. We must have points of reference. I thank you, but you must dismiss, sir. Go on.
Thank you.
Sir! Oh. 5 minutes! Yes, sir!
Does your cousin have any need of a slightly experienced Latin master?
My dearest Chipping, I greatly appreciate the sacrifice you have made, in part because of me. But you must retract your position. I beg of you, reconsider. Please, do it for me.
Too late, I fear. Marvelous friend. Please, take good care of yourself.
has become a focus of discontent. The boys are openly rebellious.
I've known him eccentric, but I've never known him dramatic. Suppose we were to allow a limited number of bursaries, would that sway him?
You mean I should back down?
No, 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 my dear fellow.
Would the governors wish me to surrender to his insubordination?
No. No, of course not. The governors do understand. It's just... I just worry. You see, Chips has taught generation after generation of some families. I showed him round here on his very first day.
Sir John, the school, and I do mean the boys and the masters, are all aware of this confrontation. We're chipping to be reinstated. My authority... gone. No leader governs by ultimatum, as I'm sure you know, but in this case, I fear, it has come to a choice. Morning, school. Good morning, school.
Good morning, headmaster.
In the few weeks since I've been headmaster, we've achieved a great deal. There's more to be done. Some of you may recognize our guest this morning. Pleasant surprise, the chairman of our governors, Sir John Rivers. And I'm sure that he will have a few words to say to us about the necessary changes which Brookfield must now embrace. Sir John.
Good morning, gentlemen. My time at Brookfield shaped my life, and I'm pleased and proud to be here today to acknowledge that. The headmaster has spoken of change, and we must all embrace change, however unpleasant. But we at Brookfield must also be aware of that sense of continuity, that sense of tradition that has made us what we are, Brookfieldians. As you are aware, one of the pillars of the school has been your and my Latin teacher, Mr. Chipping. You are also aware that we have been in danger of losing him. I now invite him to change his decision and to confirm that he will stay with us by leading us all in the school prayer.
Placed me in an impossible position.
You've done that for yourself.
Come on, sir! Yes, sir! Chips! 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 Chips!
Shine your light on Brookfield School, on her teachers,
and on her students.
Grant us the enlightenment of eternal knowledge, that we may proceed along a path of learning that has been illuminated with your grace. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, I always recognize a collie.
How are you, sir?
Oh, my dear fellow.
Mud is gray. Not brown like ours. It makes sucking noises. sucks men down.
Not supposed to drown in mud. Supposed to drown in water. Lost a boot, sir. Stepped on something. There's a body, sir.
School, we've informed the War Ministry in London that we have indeed ploughed our playing fields. We now await their directions as to which crops we shall be required to grow.
Come in. Oh. Ah. Gentlemen, Evans, Mr. John.
Hello, sir.
Oh, it's young Sexton, isn't it? Yes, it is. A bit more down to earth than I remember.
Yes, I avoid roofs, sir. So good to see you.
Well, shall we all sit down? Mr. Chipping, we want to thank you. Since Mr. Ralston decided to rejoin his regiment, you've accepted additional responsibilities at a difficult time, and we appreciate all of your efforts.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well done. Thank you.
We know that retirement could and should be your reward. But my fellow governors and I would like formally to offer you the position of headmaster of Brookfield. It's an appointment that's long overdue.
I shall be honored. Centipede calendar?
Please, sir?
All these pigs.
Sir, I fag for battles. Oh, no,
please. Don't tell me, calendar. And
do you know why? The quartermaster had a wooden leg.
Sir? Headmaster?
Beckles, make me some toast. Lancaster, see if you can't put a shine on these pigs.
Sir, we don't fag. We're not...
Precisely. Nobody fags for me, and I'm more senior than you. Pass it on.
Headmaster?
Yes, come in, woman. This wretched war has taken such a heavy toll on everyone. There isn't an easy way to say this, Morgan. I've received news that your father has been killed in action. I'm so sorry. I feel certain that he made a fine soldier. He was a fine student, brilliant linguist. He spoke perfect German. He had a good teacher.
I hate Germans. I hate them all.
I'm so sorry. It is a matter of pride, but also sad,
I fear I must announce the death of more Brookfeldians, who died fighting for king and country.
Captain Robert Mitchell Rivers, a previous head boy of this school, and the eldest son of Sir John Rivers, our chairman of governors. Subaltern Anthony Andrew Grenville of the Suffolk Regiment, killed in action at the Somme. Edward Charles Peter Hawthorne, captain in the 1st Somerset Light Infantry. Commendation for bravery, mortally wounded at the Somme. Lieutenant Michael Jeremy Atkins, missing in action with the Grenadier Guards and presumed dead. Lieutenant Colonel Stephen Charles Alderdice, 119th Battery of the Royal Field Artillery. Special commendation for bravery, killed in action. Captain James Asquith Highcroft, Oxford and Buckingham Light Infantry, missing in action, presumed dead. Lieutenant Colonel George Arthur Wallingford, Lancashire Fusiliers, missing in action. Captain Robert William Willis, Royal Engineers, missing in action. Lieutenant Colonel John Henry Reinhardt, Royal Horse Artillery, killed in action.
Edwards,
Second Lieutenant Graham Sidney Evans,
Elliot, Eversley, Ferguson.
And finally, I regret that I have to announce the sad death of a beloved colleague and a fine teacher. Those of us who knew him will be sorry to hear that Maximilian Friedman Stafel was killed 2 weeks ago. This school owes him much. Such capacities as a teacher and human being must not be clouded by issues of nationality, even in such crucial times. Individuals are not nations. Let us remember Max Stafel. Let us remember them all in our thoughts. Gentlemen, today we will call upon the services of Mr. Gibbon and his decline and fall of the Roman Empire to show us that history repeats itself. Will you turn, please, to chapter 9 of volume 2? Administration of public affairs are the principal subjects of history. Thank you, Warburton. Who will continue, if you please, Mr. Lancaster?
But the number of persons interested in these busy scenes is very different, according to the different condition of mankind.
Now, what Mr. Gibbon is saying here, or is about to say, and Mr. Gibbon would hope for fewer lightnings from the gods when saying so, is that people who are calm and occupied in peaceful countries never make war. Continue, please, Mr. Lancaster.
But a state of freedom and barbarism, the season of civil commotions, raises almost every member of the community into action, and consequently into notice.
Gentlemen, take cover under your desks, please.
Now, gentlemen, this next passage I count important enough to have you repeat after me. The irregular divisions and restless motions of the people of Germany. Dazzle our imaginations and seem to multiply their numbers. The profuse enumeration of king fails. Stay there! Nobody move!
sind Sie in Sicherheit.
Sehr danke.
The German boy sent me a charming letter when the war was over. I recall thinking at the time that he was himself a sixth former somewhere. They lost their young men too.
They all lost someone.
Is it true that you gave him walnut cake with pink icing?
My late wife, Catherine, believed it improved people. I think she was right.
Wonderful to have the photography club.
Do you remember Stoughton? I'm certain that he would have been here for today's celebrations. A beautiful singing voice. I think that's why old Weatherby was so fond of him.
Chips, how are you feeling today?
I'm hale again, thank you.
I do feel, sir, that you ought not to overdo it today.
Poppycock. Let us celebrate our history.
Sir, I don't believe you've met my wife. Darling, this is... Well, you know who this is.
Oh, I've heard so much about you.
Thank you.
Dear chap.
Hello, Chips.
Sir, it's Calendar, sir. How are you these days? Ooh,
Calendar is single-handedly responsible for the end of fanging. Oh, my dear... Collie, I'm so very pleased to see you.
So good to see you, sir.
Why don't you have a seat, sir?
Yes. I think I will, thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. And now, Mr. Chipping, Chips, the very first copy of the new history of Brookfield School, with all our best wishes.
Sir, I hope you remember me. I'm Rushton.
Of course I do. Rushton. How very nice to see you. How are you?
I'm awfully well, sir. I'd love you to meet my daughter. She knows all about you and Mrs. Chipping. I've taken the liberty of calling her Kathy.
So sad. They never had any children.
Oh. But I do have children. Hundreds of them. All boys. Unsley. Vales. Wagstaff. Watling. Warburton. Waverney. Yates, Yelland, Young. Come along, in before the bell. Oh.